Hello friends and everyone, you're welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. This video, I'm going to show you how to reuse an installed package from another project. You see, when you have a new project created, you have to install some package that you want to use. But what if in case you have installed that package on a separate project already, what can you do? Then you can reuse that package, the NuGet package. So it doesn't necessarily mean that anytime that you create package, you create project, you have to go in there and install the same NuGet packages that you have installed already in your old project. So in this video, let's take a look on how to reuse those packages. Now, as you can see, I have a project created and I've installed community2k.mvvm package. So if I go to demo and if I go to the properties for this demo, let's see. So if I come here, you can see I have it down here as an item group. So you can see I have a community2k.mvvm. The version is 8.2.1. Now I have this package installed to this project. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to copy this. Then I'll just go for notes. So notepad. Then let me paste this package here. Now I'm going to close this. Now I have this. So I'm going to open a new package here. And now with this, I'm going to create a new project. That is the same project. So create a new project. So we're going to create .NET Maui app project from the template here. So we're going to search for Maui. So .NET Maui app, and here is going to be demo one. Now you can choose the location. Now click on next, choose framework, and that is 7.0. Because when you check the app version, we use 7.0 for that .NET framework. So maybe you can decide to keep that or you can change it. So let's keep the 7.0 and I'll click on create. So now let's run this project and see what we have now. Okay, so now we have the app ready and it is running. When you go to the properties of this project, now this project properties contains only one package, that is a default one. Now we have a package that you want to load. We have installed it already, so we have it on our machine. And now we want to load this package to this project. So how can we do that? You want to load only the first one. So in order to do that, we have to first unload the project. So let's stop this. And now click on the project. And now go to unload project. So now unload project. We are in the settings now. Now let's go in there and I'll grab the project. So let's grab the package that you want to add. That is this one. Let's come to the project item group and now let's add this. Let's save this. And now you see when you come to the same settings again, we have the item group or the package here. Now let's load the project with dependencies. So reload project with dependencies, click on this, and now you see the project, the package is still there. Go to dependencies, and now let's see what we can do. We have to build this. So dependencies, let's go to the packages, and now you see we have this package over here and it is included now. Now let's build this package or let's build this project and see. So we first have to clean this. Then when we are done, we build the project. So now done. Let's clean solution 2. So clean solution. And now let's build the project. So build this. So build succeeded. Now let's run this project. Okay, so it has run successfully. Now let's test with the package that we install. Let's test with a package or a simple view So let's see. You can see we have the main page here. Let's try to create a content and also view model, because we've installed the community2k.mvvm. So let's test it with a collective view here. So I'm going to go to the project. Now let's stop this debugging. And I'm going to add a class. And maybe we can use this as customer. So let's have customer name, so that is public. And now here, we're going to have ID, and we're going to have name too. So let's see, customer, this is string, and that will be name. Okay, this is what we have. Let's create our view model. So we create a class, and now we say this is main page view model. Now in this, let's inherit from observable objects, and observable object is a class found in the package that we install, community toolkit. So if, let's see if it will be able to work here. So observable object. Okay, now let's create a constructor for this. Let's create, so public observable collection. Then we say customer. We say customers. So equal to new. Now let's call the method. So let's say load customers. Load default customers. Let's call that method. And now in here, let's create this method over here. So let's say customers. Dot. So here must be customers. So customers dot add, then new customer. We have an ID of one. We have name of John Doe. Let's add few ones. So new customers. So ID is equal to 2. And now name is equal to let's add one more. So customers dot add. Then we have new customer. We have ID 43. Then have name is equal to. Okay. Now let's say we have these data that we want to use in the collection view. So when this page is called, we're going to call this method, and this method is going to load this customers or this data to this customer object collection. Let's inject this view model into the content page, and that is the main page.cs. So let's clear this button. That's the default one, or we can maintain it. So let's clear this. And now in here, let's inject this. And now we say binding contest equal to this main page. Let's clear this. Now we are saying that it is inaccessible because, let's go to the main page. So here must be public partial class. So public partial class. Now let's go back to the main page and this one is off. Let's register the view model and its view in the program CS file. So we say builder.services.add transients, and now we have to say main page view model, and let's have one again, so that services dot add transient, and now we say main page view model. Let's go to our main page, and now let's clear all this. Now we're gonna use collection view. And now we say collection view dot item template. Then we're gonna say data template. So here, let's use an item source. And item source here, before we can have this, let's bind the namespace here. So view model, and now we say it is namespace, and that is demo one. So this, let's specify the data type. So X data type that we want, and that is main page view model. So main page view model, that's what we want. Now when you come here, we can ask bind it to, so we say binding, then we can have customers. Now with the data template, let's specify the data type too. And before we do that, you can use this view model. So let's set this to local. So this local, we can use this local here, and now data type, so you're going to say local dot, and I'm going to have customer. Now let's specify label, and now let's say, before we do that, let's get frame, let's have background. And inside the frame, let's put our model, or that's the label. And let's specify the text. So we bind it to the name. Okay, so we bind this to the name. Now let's save this and let's run this application and see what we have. Okay, so let's see. Alright, so you see we have the data here. So it means that although we did not download the community2k.mvvm NuGet package, but we have been able to use it in a current or new project because we have downloaded it already. Now when you download any package that we installed, it goes to your local disk. You can see when you go to the users folder and you're gonna have this NuGet package. When you open it, you're gonna have a lot of packages that you have installed. So community2k.mvvm here, it is installed already. So all these packages, what I need to do here is I have to keep the item group. I can just go there and grab the reference here and keep them. Anytime that I create a new project, I'll just unload it, add it, and I'll reload it with dependencies, and they're good to go. So that is a way to prevent downloading packages anytime that you create a new project, once you have these packages installed or downloaded already. I believe this video is helpful. Yes. So that is it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. If you like what I'm doing, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel too, so that as soon as I create a new informative lesson, you have the notification to watch it. Also, check the playlist. We have a lot of lessons and projects for you. You can just go in there and I'll take any of them. Thank you. Take care of yourself, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.